Let me very briefly take this opportunity to appeal to all my young friends who are present here today at the 24th annual youth conference of the Islamic Dawah Academy to get married as soon as possible. Get married as soon as possible. Once you have completed your studies, once you have settled down, don't delay. Don't delay. The ruling on nikah depends upon the individual. So don't just assume nikah to be a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If it becomes difficult for a person to abstain from sins without getting married, then nikah becomes incumbent. So nikah is not sunnah for everybody. Lot of people tend to assume that nikah is sunnah, so sunnah is something that is not compulsory. And if it is not compulsory, we can delay it, we can do it after 5 years, 10 years, it doesn't really matter. No, nikah is sunnah upon that person who is able to look after himself and abstain from sinful activities without getting married. But for those people who are unable to look after themselves without getting married, nikah is incumbent. And nikah will become a means of you completing your deen very quickly. Nikah will become a means of you progressing in your taqwa very quickly. So please don't delay. Get married as soon as possible. Nowadays, young boys and young girls are heard saying, I'm not ready yet. I'm not ready yet. It's not an answer. It's just an excuse. I'm not ready yet. We do not want to take responsibility of a family on our shoulders. And we want to continue roaming around here and there disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is very much disliked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please, take my advice, get married as soon as possible. There are so many worldly benefits and benefits from the point of view of the akhirah also. As soon as possible, get married. Even during your studying time in a madrasa or in college, university, if getting married is not a hindrance to your progress in your studies, even then you should get married. Get married as soon as possible. The muhaddiseen have stated that the age gap between Amr ibn As radiyallahu ta'ala anhu and his son Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was, according to one opinion, 13 years and according to another opinion, 11 years. So that means he got married at the age of either 10 or at the age of 12. And Abdullah was born when he was 11 or when he was 13. So they were much better than us. Why? Because they were able to take responsibility of a family at the age of 10 and at the age of 12. They were much stronger than us, much more intelligent. You can only take responsibility of a family if you are matured enough to look after a family. And Amr ibn As radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was a very great companion of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they used to get married at the age of 11 and at the age of 13 and at the age of 12, and we say at the age of 30 I'm not ready yet. So if you're not ready at the age of 30, you get married at the age of 35, your first child will be born at the age of 36, and when your child reaches the age of 20, you will be 56. How is an old man going to control his young son? The tarbiyah will be very difficult. The sooner you get married, the better it is, because you will be able to control your children and nurture them properly as well. Because he will be young and you will be young. You will be able to look after him. So please, from worldly perspective and also from the point of view of the akhirah, there are so many barakat. So try to get married as soon as possible. Find the right match. And in finding a match, two things. It should be a partnership. The choice of both parties. The wife or the husband should be liked by the parents and also the children. Because the children will consider the looks of the life partner. And the parents look at so many other things which we don't understand when we are young. So many other factors which are very, very important for a married life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq. Jazakumullah.